Hey, hi, hello, namaste, welcome to CR Intelligence. This is Chetan, and in this tutorial we are going to make a sci-fi weapon like this. In this tutorial I will explain you how to make any kind of art from start to finish for the VFX production. So watch this tutorial till the end so you can learn a lot. So now let's get started.
So we will start with a cube, and cube is already there. Just you need to scale it along the x-axis and then go to the edit mode, and you need to add a loop cut. So Ctrl R to add a loop cut. Then you can turn on your extra mode and then select these words and move them along the z-axis and give the proper position to these words. And we will block out the basic form for the model so we can later on add more details on it. So just use the transform orientation tools and create a basic block out for the model. And now you can see we got the basic block out, and we will create a little bit of design on it. So then you need to add one more cube, so Shift A and then add a cube, give it its proper position and give the proper scale. So this will be the cutter object, and that main part will be the cutting objects like that. And then you need to turn off that extreme mode and select your this cutter object, and then select your cutting object that on which you want to make a cut. And then you can use the boolean operation, use the bool tool which is the free add-on, and then use the boolean operation which is difference, and you will create a boolean at there easily. So then you can adjust the position of this cutter object, so you can see it is in the wireframe, so you can give the proper position to this. And after that you need to add one more cube, and we want to create more booleans on that, so that's why you need to add one more cube at there. So give the proper position to your cube, and this will be the another cutter object for the cutter object. And so we will create a cut on the cutter object, on the last cutter object. Okay, then adjust the scale, and you need to rotate it, and you need to give the proper angle to this object. Okay, and then you need to select that cutter, new cutter object, and select that last cutter object and use the boolean operation which is difference. And then you can go to the edit mode, and if you want to tweak some settings, then you can do it. You can adjust the scale and other things. Something like this you can do easily, and that's not difficult. Just move it a little bit down, and you can use the transform orientation, different transform orientation, to achieve the different result. And you need to rotate it into the different angle, so get that so it will be the parallel to the main part. Okay, after that, after giving the right position and right angle, you can Shift E to duplicate it, and then duplicate it and give the proper position. So this will be the another cutter object, and then you can select this new cutter object, and you select that last one cutter object and use the boolean operation difference. So you can see easily we have created this kind of geometry with a few cubes and with the boolean operation. Then you need to apply that boolean modifiers on all these mesh. So just select mesh each and everyone, and then you apply that boolean modifiers, and then you can delete these cutter objects. We don't need them because we don't need to adjust them later on. Okay, and now you can see the topology is not so good, and don't worry about the topology, we will work it later on. So just there are a few edges in a different angles just to maintain that shape. So you can create a little bit of topology at there, means you can connect these words. So you can remove that unwanted edges, and you can keep it as it is. We will work it later on, and we will create the right topology. So just add a loop cut like this, because I want to create a boolean at there, so that's why I have added the loop cuts. And then you can select everything and then mesh symmetrize. Choose the proper axis for the symmetry, that's also the important thing. And I would like to take the symmetry after creating single details, because I can understand the form of the model and I can visualize it very well, so I can create more design on it. Okay, then you need to add one more cylinder, so just delete this cube because we don't need it. Cube, we will go with a cylinder and add a cylinder with a less word, something like 8, and this will be the cutter object, and we will create a boolean on the base mesh. Okay, just give the proper position to this cylinder, and then you can scale it along the x-axis. Okay, just scale it, press S and then X to scale it along the x-axis and give the proper position. And then you need to use the boolean operation, which is the difference. So just select your cutter objects, give the proper position and the scale to it, and then you can use the Boolean operation. So just orbit around your mesh and then select these objects to objects and then use the Boolean operation difference. And you can adjust the scale, position of this cutter object later on also, because we didn't apply that Boolean modifier yet. Okay, now everything is looks good, then you can go and you can apply that modifier. Just orbit around your mesh and see if it's good, then you can go ahead. Okay, just select your base mesh and then apply that Boolean modifier. And if you want to tweak few things, then you can do here. And then you can delete this cutter object, we don't need it. Now you can select everything and mesh symmetrize. And now we will try to create a little bit of design on this particular model. So here I want to create a few more designs, like if you see something like a industrial instrument, something like that, then you can see such kind of design. Just I add one more cube add there, like infrastructure instrument, something like that. We want to create that teeth kind of shape. So just adjust the scale of this cube, and you need to use the Boolean operation here. So we will use that array. You can use the array, otherwise you can shift D to duplicate it, and just you can take a duplicate of 3, something like is fine, and then just give the proper position. The rotation is not here good, so we will keep it as it is, and then join them all, and then use the Boolean operation, which is difference. Okay, so something like this you can do. And now you can see we don't get the tamper kind of shape which I wanted. So that's why we need to apply that modifier, and then we need to select these words and we need to move them in the different along the x-axis. So just select these words, you can use the extra mode and move them along the x-axis, and just move them a little bit along the z-axis, so we will get the right tamper kind of shape which will look decent. And now you can see that's look good. I got the desired result. And now we need to create a little bit of design on it. So this is, you can see the topology is not so good on this particular model. We need to edit the topology later on. After creating the complete block out, complete booleans on this model, you can go ahead and you can recreate that topology. So just I have added one more cylinder here with the 8 words. And just you need to give the proper position to this, and we will use the Boolean operation one more time here. So just select your cylinder, and you need to add the array modifier. Just give the proper position it. I want to create that wave kind of shape. So if I use the Boolean operation here, you can see this kind of thing I will get, this kind of shape I will get. So just add array modifier on this cutter object, means like that cylinder, and increase the count, array count. 3 is fine, or you can go and increase the little bit more and give the proper count, and then you can give the right position to this cutter object, and then you can apply that modifier, so you will get this kind of waveform design. So just apply that modifier. Before, you need to apply the array modifier and then apply that Boolean modifier on the base mesh, and now you can see the topology is not good, but we got the design and we got that basic idea for the design. Then select everything, mesh, and then symmetrize. Then you need to select these faces, and we will delete these faces because we want to take the symmetry and we will rotate it, so don't need to worry about those faces. So now we need to think about the topology a little bit, and we need to add more loop cuts, and we need to create a right topological structure added there. So you can select this word, right click, and then connect vertex path. If you do that, you will get little bit of messy result, because there are very few geo on this model. So that's why you need to use the control R to add the loop cuts. You can't add the loop cuts, you can add words at there, because the proper topology is not there. So that's why you can add the words, and then select these words, right click, and then connect vertex path. And you need to connect the words like this in a proper way, so we can add the sub-D modifier also. So this is something like a little bit tricky thing, creating the right topology for your model. Then you can take the symmetry, so select everything, mesh, and then symmetrize. So that's why I like to take the symmetry after completing little bit of tasks also. So I will get an idea where I need to add more loop cuts and how I need to go ahead. So just I have added a few loop cuts here, then select these words, right click, and then connect vertex path. That's not a difficult game, adding the loop cuts and creating the good topology. It's not difficult, you can do it easily. Just follow the rules and try to create the chord-based topology. A few triangles are always fine. And make sure wherever it's a boolean, you need to create one loop at there, so you won't deform the form of that model. So you will get the right shading. Okay, so you can see I have added the loop cuts, means words, and I'm using the knife tool. Just use the knife tool because it's little bit difficult to add the loop cuts. So that's why I have added the words, and then you need to use the knife tool to connect these words. So sometimes you need to delete a few faces because the edges gets overlapped to each other, and it is quite difficult to find out those edges. So better way is to delete those faces and recreate them one more time with the right words and with the right position of the words and edges. So you can see those edges were overlaps, so that's why we need to delete the overlap edges, so we will get the good topology. And then select everything, mesh, symmetrize. Then you need to select, you can do the select vertex point here. So right click, select vertex point, and then connect these words. But sometimes it's not work because there are very less topology. So then in that case, you can use the knife tool, select the first point, select the second point, and then press enter to finish that operation. So just create a cut like this and merge the words, select everything, and then press M and then merge by distance. So any word will be, double words will be there, it will get merged. And then you need to create the right topology. You need to add necessary loop cuts on your model so it will look good, and we can add the sub-D modifier and we can create the right topology on the model. So here you just need to fill these gaps, so that's why you need to add more loop cuts in the right amount, and then you can fill this gap easily. So select everything, mesh, and then symmetrize. Any double edge will be there, just remove that edge. You can dissolve it, Ctrl X to dissolve that edge. And now you can see I'm facing a little bit of difficulty because these are the double edges and I'm not getting the right edge loops at there. So that's why you need to dissolve these edges, or you need to delete those edges because these are the double edges. And create a proper topology. You can select the face loops, and so you can understand easily where are the double edges or where are not. If I try to add the loop cuts, it won't work if there will be any double edge or the words gets merged or any kind of triangle is there. You can add the loop cuts easily with just, there will be the chord then. Then you need to add the sub-D modifier on it, and you need to find out where you need to add more loop cuts and where you need to create the right topology, right edge loops to get that right result. So here I need to create the edge loop, so you can add the loop cuts like this, and then we need to edit the topology like this. So as you, if you have watched my previous tutorial in which I have explained how you can create the loop structure around the particular boolean. So select these words, right click, and connect vertex path, and then you can dissolve these edges. So you will get one face loop structure around that particular boolean. Something like this you can do easily. So just dissolve these edges and you can divert those edges and you can add necessary loop cuts at there to maintain that form. And now you can see we got that face loop structure at there. So just add the necessary loopers here. Then turn on your sub-D modifier and you can add the loopers wherever it's necessary. So you can see we have started to get the good shading on the model as we add the necessary loop cuts on the model. In the sub-D workflow, necessary edges, the supporting edges are very important because they help to maintain the form of the model. So just need to select these words, right click and then connect vertex path and create a loop structure around these booleans also. You can dissolve these edges like this. So select these words, right click and then connect vertex path and just create one face loop structure at there. Then you can dissolve the unnecessary edges and you can add the later on the edge loop it will be necessary then to maintain the form. So now you can see I have created the right face loop structure around that particular booleans, so it will help me to maintain the form, and then you can add the loop cuts if it will be necessary then. Then we need to work a little bit here and you can see the model looks decent a little bit and we need to work it more to get the right result. So just select these words, right click and connect vertex path, or you can use the knife tool. So just add the loop cuts here and then create a light topology, and here also you need to create that face loop structure. So that's why you need to add the necessary loop cuts and create a chord based topology and those loops which will goes all around to the boolean. So you can see I'm not getting the proper booleans at there, so you need to work it a little bit. So just select these edges and then dissolve them and try to achieve that face loop structure. Then you can select everything and then mesh symmetrize and choose the proper axis for the symmetry. Same thing you need to do here for this underneath loop cuts. So then you can add the necessary loop cuts with the Ctrl R, and now you can see we have started to get that right topological structure for the model because we can add the loop cuts on this particular model. So if you are getting the right loop cuts on your model, this means your topology is chord based topology. And then add loop cuts here to maintain the form, and that's look good, decent. So now we need to work on this boolean which we have created with the cylinder, and this is little bit tricky boolean and we need to find out the solution to work on this particular boolean. So just I have dissolved that, but it won't work. So we need to find out the right solution for it. So just you need to scale it along the x-axis and make it straight. So that will be the code. You can press S and then scale it along the x-axis and give the value 0 to make it straight. Then you can need to select everything and then mesh and then submit rights. And still we are not getting that right result, so just add the loop cuts if and try to get the right result. If you are getting the right result and you are happy with it, then you can keep it as it is and you can go ahead. Otherwise you can start to work on it on a little bit more. Just I have deleted that bottom part because that was unnecessary part, so that's why I have dissolved that. And you can see if you add more loop cuts, you will deform that cylindrical part also, so that's also you need to maintain. So just I have added a few more loop cuts here and I have taken that part a little bit up so I can avoid that boolean effect. So just you need to take it a little bit up and so you can get a little bit of different direction to that edges and you can avoid that boolean effect and you will get the right design at there. So just I have added a few more loop cuts here and you can the scale tool with a normal orientation. And if it work good, then you can keep it as it is, and if it's not, then you need to work on it a little bit. So just make it straight and then select these words, loop cuts, and then make it straight. So just we need to select these faces and take a symmetry, and here I want to create a little bit of design, so just use the insert operation and then you need to use the proper scale and then use the extrude along the normal and extrude it inside, and then you can use one more time insert operation. So in this way you can create a boolean at there. And that's look good. We need to add few more loop cuts on this particular boolean so we will get the right result. So just select these edges and move them, or you can use the edge slide and then add necessary loop cuts on this particular model in this particular part, so you will get the right result. And now we have got the good shading, good form for the model. Just take the symmetry and now you can see that's look decent. And now we need to extrude it a little bit and just we need to create a little bit of design here. We can create a little bit of design, so just I have used a simple extrude operation and then take this words a little bit up so we can avoid that weird shading effect. Just I have divert this edge flow and I have take it little bit up along the z-axis so I can avoid that boolean effect. Then you need to work on this topology so you can avoid this little bit extra edges on your model. And here I want to create a little bit of design, so that's why you need to add the necessary loop cuts on the model and then you can start to create a little bit of design if you want them. So just I have used the edge slide, or you can use the move tool also. So use any kind of tools and then create a little bit of design, just extrude inside it a little bit. And then you need to add the necessary loop cuts to maintain that form. So it's totally depend on your loop structure. So control R to add the loop cuts and add 3 loop cuts like this, 3 or 5 loop cuts like this, and then you can start to create a little bit of design at here. Create a little bit of simple design, and with a simple extrude and insert operation, you can create a little bit of design here. And give the proper position to your loop cuts so you can maintain the form for your model. And now you can see that's look good. So easily we have created this kind of Boolean design. And that's not difficult. And now you can see we got the decent look for the model, and we can take it to the next level. So just select these faces and just I want to create a little bit of design over here. So just make sure these edges should be straight, so you can use the scale tool to make them straight and use the normal orientation at there, and then use the scale tool to make them straight. And same thing you need to do with this edge loop also. And then you can select these faces. Then press I for the insert operation. And you can see these edges are too close to each other, that's why I was facing little bit difficulty. So just select these faces and use the insert operation right there. And then you need to use the extrude along the normal. And I will use the rotation tool here and just rotate it a little bit, just to create a little bit of different kind of design right there. You can try different things on your model so you will get a different result and which will look good with the sub-D workflow. So give the just proper position and you can use the move tool for that. And just add the necessary loop cuts on your model so you can maintain the form of the model. And now that's look decent. So we have created the decent design here. And now you can see the model looks decent. And just you need to take this and you need to block out the next part for the model. So you can use the simple transform orientation tool like move tool and extrude tool and create this kind of shape, the curve shape for your model. So just use the proper method for that. You need to use the simple move tools and the rotate tools to get that proper shape. And you need to tie this thing many times to get that right result. And then you can add the necessary loop cuts to maintain that curve form and give them the right position that loop cuts. And so you can create this kind of hand kind of shape and then set the origin at that particular loop cuts, ending loop cuts, and snap your 3D cursor to that particular ending. And then you can select everything and then you can take the symmetry along the Z-axis. So you can symmetrize it and you will get this kind of shape. And that's look decent. So basically this will be the handle parts. So this will be the main part of that sci-fi weapon and we will create the handle from the back side. And you can rotate it and you can see it will look from the top view also. So now we'll create a little bit of detail on this model, so that's why I need to delete this part. We can take it symmetry later on because I want to create a little bit of details in this bottom part. So that's why I have deleted, so it will be the easier to work on this part. So then select these faces and just we will create a simple detail, not too complex detail. Just use the insert operation and create a little bit of boolean side there with the insert operation and extrude along the normal. So just one more time use the insert operation, press I for the insert operation and adjust the scale. You can scale it down a little bit along the different axis to get the proper face loop structure and then extrude along the normal and move it a little bit along the Z axis. And create this kind of simple boolean operation. Simple design, not too complex. And then press I for the insert operation one more time. Just to add one more loop, add there and then you can scale it along the Y axis. So you will get this kind of shape that look good. And then add one more loop cut here. And then you need to add one more loop cut at here also. So this looks good. Okay, so now we will create the little bit of design here. Simply booleans we will create here with the insert and extrude along the normal operation. So that's why you need to give the first the proper position to your loop cuts and you need to maintain the proper space in between these loop cuts. So that's why you can add the loop cuts and then dissolve them and then add one more time the loop cuts. And then you can select these faces. Make sure you add the proper loop cuts first of all. And give the right position to them. Then add loop cuts like this, 4 loop cuts, or it's totally depend on the size of your model. And then add loop cuts like this and then select these faces and use the simple insert operation and then use the extrude along the normal operation. So in this way you can create a little bit of design here and that's look good. And just if you want to add more loop cuts then you can add it. And you need to see what will look good for your design. So then you need to select these faces, press I for the insert operation and create a little bit of design here with the same technique. Not a big deal here. So we are using the simple and easier method, simple and easy techniques, and we can create an amazing kind of details on the model. But make sure your topology should be good, then only you can add any number of details on your model. If your topology is not good and you are using the sub-D workflow, it is a little bit difficult to add more details. So that's why you should have the good topology on your model. So here I want to create a little bit of design. Okay. And then add loop cuts like this. and then you need to use the loop cut, few more loop cuts at there, and then you can use the insert operation also. So just select these faces, press I for the insert operation, and you can add more loops at there. And come here, and here we want to create a little bit of design. So that's why you can select these faces, and I will use the simple insert operation and then extrude along the normal operation. So then just need to delete these faces. So because we will use the symmetry, so that's why we need to delete these faces. And now you can see that's look good. Then I have taken the symmetry here, and just need to create the now the handle part. So that's why use a simple cube and quickly block out the basic form for your model. Like that handle holding part. And that's not difficult, you can easily block out this kind of thing. And you need to use the simple tools like a move tool, extrude tool, scale tool, these kind of tools. And with these tools you can block out the basic form for the model. Then add the loop cuts and create a little bit of design over here. Just simple things. Then delete those faces and then select everything and then mesh symmetrize and take the symmetry along the z-axis. And now you can see, just I'm adding the loop cuts here and make them straight along the z-axis. And then you can select these faces, face loops, and press I for the insert operation, and then extrude along the normals and extrude inside it a little bit. And then you can add more loops out there, and now you can add more topology on it, means more loops to maintain the form. Just give the right position to it, then select everything, mesh, and then symmetrize. And then just dissolve these loop cuts and add new loop cuts out there. And now we need to keep the little bit of curve form here, so that's why you can use the scale tool. So just select this loop cut and scale them along the y-axis like this to maintain that curve form. So then you need to add the subdivision surface modifier, so just add the subdivision surface modifier and add the necessary loop cuts. To maintain that form, we need to add the more loop cuts on this model. And now you can see that's look good. Just add blue cuts here. And now you need to create the right topology add there, so you can edit this topology and you can create that edge flow, means face loop structure which will go all around to the mesh. And then you can see that's look good. Just adjust the scale here so it will look good. So then add loop cuts like this and then select these faces. And here I want to create a little bit of boolean, so I will can use the loop tool here, but make sure you use the proper loop tool because these faces are in the different dimensions, so that's why you need to match them first upon, and then you can use the loop tool to get that right result. So just select these faces, and then you can press I for the insert operation, and you can use your extreme mode to manage them, like to make them similar, and then use the loop tool and then adjust the scale. Make sure your individual origin should be on and then adjust the scale, and you can scale it along the different axes to make it proper circular shape, and then use the insert operation one more time, and then you can use the loop tool or locked operation which is there in the loop tool, or you can delete the edges and you can use the breach edge loop. So just delete these faces and then select this edge loop and then breach edge loop. This thing you can do. And now you need to add the necessary loop cuts on it. So just Ctrl R to add loop cuts and add necessary loop cuts, so you will get the good shading. Then select everything and mesh and then symmetrize. Okay, so here I want to create a little bit of design, that's not difficult. Just need to select these faces and press I for the insert operation and then extrude along the normal. So just select these edges and double tap G for the edge slide, and use the edge slide a little bit to give the right position at there, so you won't get that overlap edges and those weird results because of that. And then turn on that sub-D modifier and add necessary loop cuts. So just select these faces and scale them along the x-axis to make them straight. And now that's look good. So now you can see the wireframe and its topological structure. And now we need to create a little bit of design on it so it will look good more. So here you just need to adjust the scale according to the first part and give its proper position. And then shift A to add a cylinder, and we will create that nozzle part for this weapon. And the next design, it's very easy. Just I have used the simple primitives, like a simple objects, and easily you can create this kind of thing. And there is no any kind of hard topological structure is there, so you can easily create next level details. So just first we need to block out the things, then you can start to add more details on it, and if it's necessary, then create a right topology for that particular model. So in this way we have created this model, the sci-fi weapon. I will add later on the bolts, nuts and all these things to add more details on it, and it will look decent. Just you need to UV unwrap this proper, and you can use the texturing, any kind of texturing software to texture it, and you can see the edge flow. This is the high poly production ready models for the VFX production. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Bye bye, see you in the next video. Take care.